All right, chorus for Lion Eyes. Every time, just before the chorus, instead of, I noticed that through most of the song, the verses end a lot with the C and the D, except for the first verse, it stays on the G. So once we get through this, we did all the other parts in the last video. So now we're going to do the chorus where he goes, you can't hide, C, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. That's the hard part. So down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down. Notice how I use my three fingers here. And I take finger two down. That's a cool trick. I can remember when I always played G chords like this, and then my teacher taught me. By the way, if you are having a hard time with videos online and stuff, find somebody that you can do one-on-one classes with. I still do one-on-one classes, and I've been playing for since I was 8, so 100 years now. No, but no, I've been playing for excuse me, quite a while, and. Anybody who's better than you, knows a lot more than you, like a professional player would be the best. Somebody who plays out live and is really studying and working hard at it. Don't just get anybody. And make sure they have lots of cool ideas to help you. Like, this is a great idea here to help you guys get from guys and girls, ladies and gents. Don't want to not include everybody, so anybody who's playing an instrument. Trying to get these two fingers to come down like this. So this is the kind of stuff I teach at TJ's easyguitar.com that's still being built. But it will be up and running shortly. So what we do is we have all these exercises like this. First thing I'd ask you to do is just try to move these two down. Right, like that. And then try to add finger one here on string two with it. It's still a C chord, and you can leave your pinky there because that's what they're doing in the song. They're going off the chorus, C, and then all of a sudden 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. Good exercise would be 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. So that's basically the idea of that split bar, we call it, where we're getting three beats on this chord and 4 and 1. So we're actually ending on 4 and here. Then we get to back to the G. So I'll start the first line of the chorus again. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Now E minor. Tricky one to get to. Those changes to help you get through that are on my website as well. To A minor. Then we get hit to D. Then we're back to just G. Now here's a really tricky chord where they use this G9. So G9, it looks like we've got a finger 2 here on 6, a finger 3 here on string 4. Pinkies on string 2, these are all in fret 3. That sounds like a pretty chord right there. And really it's just a G7. And then adding finger 1 behind those 3 on fret 2, string 3. So that's something, some people will just cheat and use their G major 7 at that point. But I am finding the more I listen to it, we really need to hear that 9 in there for the vocalist. And then C, and then your A major, and an A minor, and a D, and back to the intro. G, G major 7, C, C, down to B, A minor, D, and G for 2. Starts in the verse 2 again, ending with just our C and our D. We'll have a listen to that one. Coming around, there's a lot of stuff going on in this. I'm going to go through the chorus one more time where we're hitting our root note, our top string for G, and we get this down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Our E minor. B minor. hopefully you can see that we're barring all of these and then using these three fingers here. Some people have a hard time barring, but again, on the website, we teach you how to get manipulate your hand to do that. Try not to play too much like this, guys. It's a bad way to teach your hands, and you're wondering why you can't get things. And a lot of times, swing your hand a little bit this way for your G chord instead of being like this. And don't forget, finger two can hang over the top of it. All right, so going through this chorus again, we get this G. An E minor, then B minor, down, up, A minor. These are all one time on the chords. Back to G. G major seven. C, and then A major switches to, and then A minor, and then a D, back to our intro. Now I'll try to just play that all the way through. Maybe I'll use a song here, and we can really feel the strumming. So here we're going to come out of this verse. There it is. Now the chorus. C, G, C, G. A minor here and a D, G, G9. Back to the intro. A minor, D, G. First, G major 7, C. A minor, or D. Back to G. Major 7, a C, A minor. Here's where we're just end with this C to the D. C, D, back to verse again. Chord C, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, D. G, G major 7. On the major 7 there, should have been a G9, but it sounded okay, didn't it? So if you're having a hard time changing to that G9, then use a major 7 for some fun. Music's hard, so. So now we just went to intro, back to verse. Again, we're gonna end on this C D thing. Alright, did it again. I think this time you're just gonna go to verse one and ends with two G's. I'll find out in a second here once we get through this verse. Listening as I'm playing G, G major 7, C. I always do that walk down on the A. Yeah, it stayed on the G twice there. Great. Now we're in the verse 2 again. with that. Off the C here, we go to A minor, C, and we get a G, 1, 2, and 3, and C and G. Chorus. Oh yeah, well, that gives you an idea on getting through the song a little bit, and there is an ending to it. I'll put that on my next video, but getting that strum really good is important. 1, 2, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down. Excellent. So I hope that really helps you guys through Lion Eyes. I'll post the ending. I'll do that on my next video as the ending. All right. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.